Indeed, in the early months of repatriation, there was a lot of hits and misses. No, maraming mga naging problema doon sa repatriation. But by around June, when the Department of Labor and Employment already instituted OASIS, the Overseas Assistance Information System, this was mentioned in the presentation of Dr. Andy, the OASIS database, somehow some order on how the repatriation process is going to be like, some order was achieved. So much so that by June or July, the discussions already focused on reintegration. What do we do with the people who have returned? Nagustuhan ko rin, I also liked the outline that Ms. Nori presented, that actually when we think of OFWs that are affected by the pandemic, it's not only the repatriated workers really that are at the focus of our attention. It's a diverse population. You have the stranded individuals, those who were about to leave for their contracts and then with the high hopes that, oh my goodness, they're going to work abroad and they will be able to provide better for their families. That was interrupted by the pandemic. And then there's also the case of those who are stranded. They are based abroad, about to return to the Philippines, but they were stranded, particularly in the hard lockdown months of April to May.